All right, welcome everyone to SDG Weekly, Shooting Game Weekly, episode number 33. And this week, it is covering Daedra Empty. This is a Japanese doujin game, which was localized just recently by Rockin' Android. I believe that's correct. Mm-hmm. And this week, we're going to have G-Cubed. As a guest on the show, and he is actually representing Rockin' Android for this episode, and we're going to talk about Daedra Empty and how it works out. So, hey there, G-Cubed. I want to call you Game-Cubed.
I get that a lot, actually. It's either G or G-Cubed.
So, yeah, thanks for coming on.
Not a problem.
And, of course, I got my co-host here, Frenetic.
Hey guys, F-Man's in the house.
And Soda will be getting us a quality stream as well because it's going to really help out because this game definitely has a lot of kind of particle effects and those type of things.
Oh yeah.
So it probably would look kind of crappy if I was doing the stream today. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so...
Hey Soda, that sweet Soda stream. Yay! We love that sweet soda stream, guys. The original soda stream.
I think you know something that I don't. okay. All right, so Daedra Empty. GameCube, how do you want to kind of intro this game? I mean, what's kind of the history behind the release, I guess, of the localization? If you have any info about that, I guess.
Well, I think I came into Rockin' Android a little bit late for that, to know exactly the history behind it. But
what about what made the company decide to do that, choose that game, or you have any insight on that?
Well, I believe one of the people who had worked for us was kind of just looking around and see what games clicked for him, and he kind of saw this, and he was like, this game needs to happen, and kind of contacted my boss, and he was like, we need to get this.
Right.
And
right. So. It's definitely, it's pretty unique and pretty awesome, I think, for just a doujin game, which would just be basically a fan-made game.
Yeah.
Right? And so this is one guy that made this game, correct?
I believe it's either one guy or a couple of different people, but definitely less than I'm gonna say five.
Like the main guy is like this. Is it the Frozen guy?
Frozen Orb, I believe.
Frozen Orb. Okay, that's kind of the guy behind it. And yeah, the very first impression of Daedra Empty is it's kind of like a really modern Tempest-like game. Where you fly on a large horizontal field, and you can choose which direction you move in. Mm-hmm. So it definitely reminded me of Tempest right away.
Yeah, I got a Defender feel.
Or
too.
Yeah, that's what I meant, Defender.
Yeah. So, oh yeah.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Oh, okay.
Those two mixed up for some reason.
Kind of had a bit of a Suguri vibe a little bit. If you were if this play field is a lot larger. And you were able to go a little bit everywhere, so that's the kind of feel that I had got from it. So,
sorry, what game?
Suguri.
Suguri, what's that?
It's another actually one of our games, but it's like a bullet hell fighting arena game.
Yeah, so. It's really cool.
It's
also known as like Acceleration of Suguri or something like that.
Yeah,
too. Yeah, I bought that. It's great too, guys. Get that too.
I see. Yeah. Yeah, so it's kind of got that going for it. The defender feel, but it kind of expands on it with kind of a lot of firepower, and I guess the firepower it would be kind of unique things. What else would you say makes the game unique from Defender?
Well, I can right off the bat say what makes this game a lot more different from just bullet hells in general is that, normally in bullet hells, it's very precise. You have all these, bullet patterns that you can memorize. You don't really get that a whole lot in Daedra Empty. It's very, here's bullets, bruh. And it's up, you know, there's no real set pattern to them, so it's, you know, you have a little bit of a break with the shield, which we'll probably talk about later. So,
okay, sure.
Yeah. I had a neat feel because usually in games you can't control the scrolling speed, you know. But this one is, you know, it's in a horizontal, and you kind of like move through the landscape rather than, you know, you're moving, scrolling at a constant rate, and like you said, like, okay, here's this pattern, here's this next pattern, here's this next pattern. So it doesn't feel punishing like randomness, but you feel like you have the control of where you want to move within the world, you know.
Yeah, I did kind of get that impression. Like, you really can just kind of strategize your position wherever you want and, like, without a lot of repercussion because of the game mechanics. Yeah. So, I don't know why we... I suppose we can get into just the basic game mechanics then. You have your regular shot. There's about four buttons in this game?
About four different buttons, minus the pause button, of course, but...
So, yeah, you got your regular shot, which you level up. There's a leveling up system in the game as you go through the stages. And then you got a turbo. When you activate it, it actually shoots some bullets, but when you activate it, it also makes you invincible for a small period. Is that correct?
Yeah, it also changes. So you get to choose two different bullet shots. There's like six different unlockable whatever.
Okay, yeah, and the turbo uses the alternate shot.
Yeah.
Okay. And then there's a bomb button, which is called the SS in this game. It's a really crazy bomb. I'm still not sure exactly what's happening when I use it, but...
It's a very weird mechanic, that one, but once you start kind of getting used to it, it's like you get all sorts of rewards just from using it.
But it sucks in bullets like a vacuum, and the bullets aren't even a problem, and then, like, you're flying around just, like, blowing up everything.
So when you use a...
Oh, go ahead.
So when you, like, tap the button, you're able to, like, suck in what's known as coins. It's kind of like little power-up. It's stuff that you get used to level up your different abilities and whatnot during the breaks. And if you kind of tap it, you're allowed to kind of suck in those coins. But if you press and hold it, it not only, you know, sucks in the coins, but it gets rid of all of the bullets on the screen. And if you survive, it doesn't make you invincible, but if you survive a set amount of time, it gets rid of all the bullets again.
So
So it's a little bit of risk and reward on that.
Okay, so that's what's going on there. Cool.
Yeah.
Then kind of the other main, really the main mechanic I think that's probably good to understand is that, yeah, you have a barrier which recharges basically constantly, and it reaches 100%. When it's 100%, you can take a bullet. That's correct. And then your barrier disappears, and then if you get hit again, then you lose one piece of your life bar.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yep, okay. But you can have the barrier recharge, of course, again. And interesting note is that you get points by getting your shield recharged. So for people who love to top score.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
It's a really good tip then.
In fact, the lower the lives you have, the more points you get just for having your shield recharged. So that's a little...
Oh, wow. Already getting to the advanced scoring here.
A little, yeah. A little risk.
Oh, yeah.
So it took me a while to figure that out, like, first impression. Like, I was like, wait, can I get hit? Can I not get hit? But I figured it out. And, you know, recharges pretty quickly. And then, like, if you use that turbo... Which, you know, kind of, it's like the turbo speeds you up along with using your that alternate shot. But if you use the turbo right, like, you can really escape a lot of bullets with that thing. Like, the invincibility period must be like, what, like a whole like 3 seconds or something?
Maybe
like,
even
like 2 seconds.
Yeah, it's
pretty crazy. Like, and so the first time you play it, like, if you had to abuse that turbo like no other.
Yeah.
Because it's quite awesome.
It is.
And then the game kind of ramps up. So, I mean, yeah, so those are the kind of basic buttons that we use in the game. But then there's the stage progression. So do you want to talk a bit about that?
So the first two stages are pretty rudimentary.
I guess it's kind of like up as well.
Kind of getting like showing you, okay, you know, this is a stage, you know, this is a, you know, on the second level, this is a boss, you know, kind of like putting you through the ropes. And then in the third level is where it really starts to ramp up. And we were actually demoing this at Anime Expo, and oh boy, that third stage just costs so many. I mean, it's pretty rough for people who aren't really, really good with bullet hells, but it's still a lot easier than some of the other ones.
Yeah, it seems to be the theme with bullet hells. It's just like you can easily be overwhelmed if you're not familiar, but if you know, like, the mechanics, like that turbo, if you know what that turbo does, like, I think it really helps out there.
Most certainly, yeah.
So, like, yeah, after each stage, you have the various things you can level up by spending the coins that you earn from defeating enemies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And
that's, like, your main shot, the turbo shot. You can buy bombs with coins, I believe is one of them.
However, when you buy a bomb, it takes a priority over your... So, like, you can't choose between which bombs you want to use. So it's a little bit... risk and reward yet again, where, okay, I know I can survive so long in a stage without using a bomb. Let's see if I can, save this for a big boss or something.
That reminds me. So then you also actually earn bombs by leveling up. Is that correct? Is that what happens in the stages?
I have not actually been able to pinpoint exactly what gives you the leveled up bombs. But
yeah, because I think I was like playing it, and then I was all of a sudden I had like four SSs, and I was like, hey, I didn't buy those.
Yeah, so... no, I've been still trying to figure that out as well. Okay. I think when you get have to use a continue, you get four, but I'm not 100% sure on that.
Oh, really? Okay. I think because I thought I saw something in the quick manual or something in the game that said that you like actually there's like an experience system, like as you're getting the some of those items are actually experience points that you're getting and then you're leveling up. Like, is that true?
Yeah, the coins are what you use to level up.
Oh, okay. So,
and lose all your lives and you have to continue, you actually lose all the coins that you had with you. Okay. So, and yet again, more risk and reward, where if you want to save up your coins for something you really want and you lose all your lives, well, you kind of.
What were the other things to upgrade in the thingy that we didn't mention?
You can upgrade your turbo.
Okay.
Your speed.
Oh, yeah, the speed, right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Normally, speed is very, like, you don't want to upgrade speed. You know, this is a bullet hell. You want to, you know, be moving really slow and dodging all those bullets. But speed is actually really, really, really good in this one because it upgrades a lot of your, I think it upgrades your shield, I believe. It upgrades your, your overall movement, which... you know, just to collect all sort, you know, all the coins is very valuable.
Yeah.
And getting out of the way of you'll see lasers later on in this game, but lasers are pretty damning for sure. Because they'll be homing in on you, and you know they always grow at a certain speed. So, I mean,
And then what was I going to mention? I don't know. Forget.
Joe, is that a cue that we should just get into the gameplay now? We'll go to the video.
I suppose we can. Yeah. Is there anything else you want to mention before we get into it? I guess now would be the time.
Here's the story. I'll read the story a little bit in the manual that they provided, that Rock and Android provide. So it's called Deidre Empty, Wish for a Dreaming Tomorrow. Above the sky in the far land, I can see the light of my sister's beliefs. A young girl soars through the air upon a black dragon, hoping to find her sister, whom she misses with all her heart. Questions flood her head as those who would stop her flood the skies. Only the one she seeks can put to rest the feeling in her heart. Will the strength of her wish and the power of her dragon be enough to succeed?
All right, will it?
Will it? Let's see.
All right, well, I remember what I was going to mention. And then, yeah, so, like, after you beat or beat the game and get some coins or whatever, you get actually you earn more different types of firepower that you can equip at the beginning of the game, I noticed as well. So, I mean, yeah, there's a lot of different firepower, too, but,
yeah,
you start out the game. Yeah, I mean, there's, like, other modes and stuff, too. We'll get to that, though. I suppose we can get into the video because we have talked a bit. In detail here about what we're going to see. I think people got an idea of what's going to happen here. So let's get a countdown going and we'll start watching your gameplay of your 1cc attempt, I guess, right?
maybe.
The 1cc attempt. Will you do it? No spoilers there.
No spoilers!
People who paid attention to the intro have already seen it.
Oh. Well. Eh.
Let's go!
I forget that. Alright, I'll do the countdown then. It'll be 3, 2, 1, click. Yep. 3, 2, 1, click.
Ooh, I love that intro. Ooh, so
good. It is a nice little...
Yeah, good job, intro. Guys.
Thank you.
The frozen orb.
Frozen orb. Oh, I love this music.
It is so relaxing just to listen to it.
Yeah, it's so diaphanous, you know, is one that I like, the word that comes to mind. So,
yeah. It's like,
it is nice music. That kind of is the impression right away, especially with the title music.
Yeah. A couple of times I've actually listened to this ride out and as I was just doing work, and I was just like, oh, this is so nice. just doing my work.
Nice. And I like how you're letting it play out here.
Yeah. Look at those cloud texturing. Oh, by the way, this is on Steam Greenlight, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, guys, vote for it. Vote for it, please.
It really deserves to be on Steam. There's a lot of games, but this one.
All right, so here you go, into the first screen.
Now, I know it shows you a little bit how to actually like all the controls for that, but what's really nice is that you can actually configure all of the controls within this game. So it's if you don't like where a button is, you can just go into the config menu and it just.
Yeah.
I actually used the second setup myself. Where had strafe as the R button. So like, oh, we didn't mention the strafe. I forgot about that. So like, you can.
Oh, that's pretty important.
Yeah, that's pretty important. You basically turn yourself left or right, and it's a strafe toggle is what it is. So. Originally it starts out when you move right, you point right, and you move left, you point left. But if you toggle the strafe on and you're pointed left, you'll stay pointed left, like Smash TV or something like that.
Yeah.
And then so that becomes you really gotta like learn how to use that strafing toggling effectively quickly. So the weapon selection.
So what's really interesting about this, and I still haven't pinpointed exactly, what combination of bullet shots, change. But if you, at certain two combinations I found can change your bullet, like, overall, the way it functions.
Yeah.
That's what I want to say.
Yeah.
Like, a couple of times you'll watch this and it'll be like, wait, that's a different kind of bullet shot type. What is, what's going on there? And I guess it's just the two types of shots that I had chosen, and that's the only one that I found out.
I see.
So I guess there's a little bit more within this game that.
All right, so you ran into an enemy there, and the barrier went away, and so it's represented by the death bar, defense bar.
Yeah.
Bottom right. It is a bit small, the heads-up display, but once you get past that, it's not really an issue.
As long as you're just trying to avoid everything, and you kind of see like the little shield recovery, point icon in the upper right hand side. It's like, oh, okay, well my shield is back, so Plus, okay. Also, your little HUD kind of flashes red a little bit, so kind of gives you a nice name.
So what you're doing is basically locating the red kind of mid-boss or mid-bosses and try to kill them, right?
Yeah, if you want to get as much coin as possible. As otherwise, you can... The lighter levels will just destroy you without the proper...
Okay, so you get coins, buy speeded. Now, what would you recommend to buy in the store to start off with for our beginning players?
I like always going with shot and speed because, okay. Shot obviously will destroy things faster, and speed allows you to also pick up coins at a much farther range. So the more coins you get in the earlier levels, the later levels will be a little bit will be significantly easier.
I see. Now these black spots, those are spawn points. Can you shoot these black globes for more coin, or do you just kind of avoid them?
You can avoid them. I just kind of like spawn camp them, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's interesting about the coins, though, is that if you use a bomb, you can, you get actually more bombs by picking up coins. So by using a bomb correctly, you can suck up a lot of coins and then use, and then have another bomb as soon as the first one is done, so.
The advanced tips. Yeah. Are you doing it right now?
Yep, I'm doing it right.
Oh, dude, that's
now.
Yeah, that
look at all sick. It. Oh.
That is actually pretty sick.
Wow.
Yeah, so you see the coins represented as the green on the mini map.
Yeah.
Man, they're just, then they're just fucking following you. Yeah, we can swear, by the way.
Yeah.
SPG Weekly is for a mature adult audience, kind of. Well, maybe not mature, but, well.
Mature-ish?
Yeah. Yeah, there you go.
So here's the first boss, and he's not too bad, and he kind of shows you a little bit of these little destructible bullets,
right?
Show like little star things, and of course you get the waves of. Another little interesting thing about the bomb is that if you don't want to activate it, but you still want all the little coins, you can kind of just tap the bomb button, and you kind of soak up a little everything that's in your screen.
Oh, and it will not necessarily burn the bomb, right?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
It uses up a little bit of the bomb's power, but if you need, I just need a little bit of coin right now, and, it's a really nice...
Yeah, so you actually got a lot of coins because you used that trick.
Yeah.
Because I know when I was playing, I had a lot fewer coins at the end of the second stage, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, we have Saraxor from Bullet Heaven here in SGG Weekly Chat. Welcome, Saraxor.
Oh, hello, dude.
Yeah, he actually did a review on this game, which was quite good.
Yeah, please check it out, too. Much love to Bullet Heaven.
I'll link that after this as well.
And now what I'm not... What I'm doing here is not necessarily smart of me. Afterwards, you really need to go for your guard up.
Okay.
This is where the game starts ramping up, and ooh.
So, is there a visual, another visual cue that we can kind of notice for when you use the charges, or when the invincibility ends? Is there? Or do you just have to know, when you use a charge, you have invincibility for a little while?
It's a little bit of, guesswork right there. Okay, I have... Because you can also change the amount of duration that you have. So when you upgrade your turbo, you upgrade your dash. So...
I see. What about those big circles that up here? Do you know exactly what those are representing?
Big circle.
You got hit there, but I've seen another one too.
I think they're just like little visual cues of whenever. I've never really known.
Yeah.
When I'm. Oh,
so you
boy.
Don't know everything.
Yeah. There's still a lot of mystery, I think, involved in this game, which is really, really nice when you have a bullet hell shooter. It's not like, oh, I know everything in this game. It's like, huh. What do you want to mess around with and see what you can do.
yeah, just nice to kind of have that mystery element. So it's like, yeah, you're just like kind of zipping by like all sorts of enemies, and it's like you're doing all right.
Yeah, like I said, later on in this game, if you don't have, oh, here's the, so this is why I recommended getting some speed. I think I show it off here, but those lasers are nasty. There are two variants of it. Ones that kind of follow you, and the other ones that are just like this wall. I don't think he gets the chance to show it off here, but yeah, I'm not playing this very smart, I don't think. Nah, he didn't have a chance on that one.
And the nice thing about this game is that presentation is like amazing.
It's really beautiful, and I love the menu when you're choosing all your power-ups. It's like really, really relaxing and just really pretty.
So we upgraded the guard reset. Like, is that how fast your guard recharges? Is that what that is? Okay, yeah. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Dead Liar KSR from the chat said the game really punishes you for not being powered up enough at the end of the game.
Yeah,
the final battle gets tedious.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I noticed that too when I did my first run. I was underpowered. Oh, it's Kaiser, cool. So yeah, just like get that shot. I think yeah, getting the main shot up probably be good.
Yeah, I think in this one I kind of go a little bit crazy with the turbo and you know just kind of experimenting it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And what's really interesting about the turbo is, yes, it allows you to move through bullets, but it'll also allow you to damage your enemies at a higher level.
Oh, that's cool. Nice. So you can kind of ram a little bit and wear the enemies down that way.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, once again, when you see him zipping around like that, that's when he's using that turbo.
Yeah,
but like you upgraded it, so now like you're like doing like a football dash or something.
Yeah,
it's like a stiff arm almost.
It almost gets to be a little bit too much, but when you have a lot of dash and you have that shield guard and a lot of power, it's really nice to have.
You become the projectile.
Pretty much.
Wow, that's cool.
Yeah, you really feel like a powerhouse in this game, which is pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Like when, like yeah, my initial impression when I played this was like, how am I alive?
Oh my god!
Like
what?
Pretty much the same reaction there, which is actually why I like it. I like doing really dumb things in my bullet hell shooters, and it's like you can't really do that a lot in Ikaruga. You can't do that a lot in Toho because. Mm-hmm. You know, you get hit once and you're dead, but in this one, it's like, oh, I can do stupid things and possibly get away with it.
Yeah. And the gameplay is so frantic, which is really nice.
Yeah.
It's really refreshing.
Yeah. So, since it is so frantic and so visually, you know, vibrant, it doesn't feel like, you know, that criticism level towards, like, Euro shmups or Euro shooters where, like, you have a life bar and whatnot.
Yeah.
There's enough going on the screen where it's like, oh, I still feel that risk rather than kind of plodding through the environment and just like, oh, I got hit once.
And, yeah.
You know.
God dang. Yeah, this is nuts because it's like those big spawns.
Yeah.
Oh, and you used a bomb there at one point.
Yeah, the SS.
Oh, okay, yep, and then so the green fireflies are chasing you, which were points.
So here I'm like a little bit sad I can't go for the guard reset. That level is actually a real important level to get a lot of coins at, because I think that was the fourth level. So I think like you can get. I did not get a lot of coins in this one, so I'm actually going to be hurting a little bit in the next level, I think.
Sirexer asked, what direction change method are you using?
I'm using the press. So when you're pressing it, it allows you to stay in one direction. There is a toggle feature, but I personally am not too good with it.
You're referring to the strafe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so you don't actually use the toggle that much.
No.
I see. Really?
Yeah, I'm more of a, when you press it, you should, you know, lock in one direction, and then when you let go of it, you know, you're all set.
It's like the opposite to me. I was obsessed with, like, getting that right when I was first playing.
Yeah. That's actually another reason why I like it, because it's not like you have to play this way. It's very, you know, very relaxed, actually, when that, you know, as far as the control schemes go.
Yeah. It plays pretty intuitively for the most part, which is nice. Yeah.
But I think right here I'm kind of struggling.
Are you like are you smoking a joint like right now? It's like taking like taking like 5 minutes.
I'm just like I'm really hurting that I can't get that guard reset. Really hurting.
You're just gnashing your teeth right now. Guard reset.
It's really hurt because once you lose the once you get a. You know, lose all your lives, you lose all those coins. So it's like, do you really want to take that risk? And actually, you get, I'm not sure if it's just the first level and onward, but I know you get rewarded for not buying anything.
Really?
And the more you go not buying anything, you get even more points. So it's.
Another thing to mess around with.
Yeah. Though, of course, in the later levels, you're really wanting that power up.
So, your attack's getting pretty beefy at this point.
Yeah.
Kind of Darius-esque attack there. Yeah, and they just flood you. On that mini-map, you can just see them. It's like a fucking, like, the Zerg invasion.
Oh my god, yes.
Zerg Rush.
Oh man, if it wasn't for... if this game did not have this map, it would just be incredibly... Oh man.
See, you can tell when the turbo ends, because you often get hit once you run out of it.
Yeah.
The invincibility period when you activate it.
Mm-hmm.
But you can just hold the turbo though to go fast.
Like if you really need that speed to kick in, what you have isn't enough. It really helps out in the pinch.
Yeah, I really enjoyed this stage's music too. Playing, I was like, wow.
This is actually a good indication as to how set are you for the future levels. You can like get rid of all these.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah.
Because they shoot destructible bullets as well, so it's like, are you throwing out enough damage to?
This game is giving Shvermuta motion sickness. Apparently.
When you're actually playing it, it feels a lot. I don't know what it is, but I've actually gotten that too. Where Soda was saying on the chat, once you're actually watching. Playing it in 60 FPS, I mean, it actually feels really natural. At least,
yeah,
that was my feeling.
It's probably more of a reaction to watching.
Okay, this guy is another reason why you want speed, because he will just continue to try to ram into you. And
yeah, this guy's badass.
He is. He's pretty nasty.
He comes at you.
Yeah,
this is epic. When I first played this, I was like, holy shit.
Yeah, you definitely want as much speed as you can for this. Because otherwise, he takes a long time to... Ooh. Oh. Such a real...
Yeah, I just love that, you know, the bosses, you know... The game, uses all the space for like a boss battle.
Yeah.
So he was literally like flying throughout the whole field, and you had that speed to actually follow him.
Yeah.
Or rather, be followed.
Never really thought about that, but no, you're definitely right on that. He definitely utilizes all that space.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
So Axer tried to fit between the five shots. Like Gradius.
That is
I'm gonna Vic Viper it. I bet you could if you're really good.
Yeah. Oh, so now I'm considering either getting a shot. Oh, why'd I do that? Oh dear.
Why didn't you want the main?
The guard.
Oh, you want the guard?
I was like, now looking back at it, I really should have gone with the guard. But at this point, yeah. I'm thinking I might as well as get the attack, because I mean, this upcoming stage is, I mean, you'll end up seeing a pretty familiar face and quite a lot of them to be exact. So I kind of wanted to get as many coin as possible for this one. But yeah, there's a lot of strategy involved in it as well, and you can go at it so many different ways.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you're actually on your last life bar at the moment.
Yeah, and here we go. So you got. So we have the first boss again.
Oh yeah, was it a boss rush that happens?
Or yeah, level one boss rush.
Okay.
And you get quite a number of them, so I was like, ooh, do I really want the guard plus, or do I want to get as many coins as possible? And this was a bit of a gamble for me, because I don't think I do too well getting these coins.
I see. Yeah, that's one thing we did forget to mention. You have to stop shooting or hold your turbo to actually collect the green, a lot of the green coins.
Right? It increases your radius. I always have the habit of holding down the fire button, so I mean,
yeah.
I just use that bomb collection, but...
Oh, I see. You just tap the bomb every now and then if there's a lot of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. That seems pretty good.
Yeah. So like right there, I kind of use it a little bit, but...
Okay, so it's probably just better to, I don't know, like they can play it various ways.
Yeah.
You're actually kind of getting overwhelmed here.
Yeah, I think now I'm like, oh... Now I just lost my. Oh boy.
So.
Yeah, shield is not regenerating as fast as I'd like it to, and it's.
Yeah, that was pretty hairy there. Like, it was pretty surprising you didn't get hit.
Yeah, I was very lucky with that.
Cause yeah, until that defense bar says ready, like.
You have to be on your toes
Yeah, time. You're in the fray.
The good side about that is that if I was trying to top score, I'd be getting a lot of points to this, because you get, like I said before, you get a lot more points just by, just by having one more life.
One less life, you mean? Or...
Yeah, one less. Yeah, the fewer lives you have, the
gotcha.
More.
Gotcha. All right, so that's the end of the first video.
Yep.
We'll get the second one countdown. Get that ready. All okay. Frenetic, he's still with us. Haven't heard from him in a bit.
Yeah, I was wondering what happened.
I'm here, guys.
All right. Well, we're gonna get the second video ready.
All righty.
And we'll get the countdown. Let me know when you're good, Frenetic.
I am good.
All right. Countdown. 3, 2. One, click. Right into part two.
Right into part dos.
Ah, so a friend of mine actually asked me, who's also watching this, asked me, what exactly do the option power-ups do?
Dude, and you just game over.
Yeah. Oh, well.
So it's all right.
So what was really important to know is that I only had one coin when I bought all the shot power up. So I only lost one coin out of that deal. So.
Oh, right.
Oh, okay.
The game over. Okay, gotcha.
Yeah. So it was actually in that regard pretty smart of me as well, to buy the shot power up, because then I didn't lose 100 coins, just
the one. Okay.
But as I was saying about the option was that so the options are kind of like these little orbs that will fly around you or however you want them activated, and they'll do various things, like they'll either attack with a straight laser beam attack or shoot little bullets at you know, shoot bullets forward or, you know, give you a little barrier or whatever. And you actually can go get up to four of them and then upgrade them, so.
Right.
They're pretty nice to have, but with this setup, I find to be pretty well-rounded, so I don't normally go with the option types with this setup.
So the options might be better for a different setup?
Yeah. I know that there's a couple of setups where they just, where it shoots much stronger projectiles forward, but it doesn't, you know, you don't get enough of coverage. So it's kind of like important to have options shoot little bullets forward or so. Yeah, I think, yeah, here I had an SS, 4 SS plus. So, and I try using that to my advantage.
It's a mesmerizing gameplay. It really is.
I kind of get lost looking at it myself.
Yeah. Like, I just love it when you're turboing around and just, like, sucking in all these coins and...
Definitely have never seen anything quite like it.
Yeah.
Like I say, it's kind of like a modern bullet hell version of Defender.
Yeah. It's something I don't think you see a whole lot about, you know, a whole lot. No, you don't see a whole lot of these kind of styles.
Defender style?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, yeah, I could definitely see other types of shmups kind of made in this fashion.
Yeah.
I could definitely see, like, maybe a traditional kind of style where it's, like, less bullets, but, you know, more threat or something like that.
Yeah.
I definitely like the RPG elements of collecting coins, and it's like, okay, you can use these to buy to get more powerful, you know? And that's kind of needed.
I think that's appealing, too, to, like, your average person.
You're like, oh, and it's probably adds to the replay of the game a lot more. You're like, well, I want to try with an all option build, or I want to try with mostly this, or and that way you can explore the game to your liking. Mm-hmm.
2 coins short of that guard reset.
Yeah, I was pretty hurting. Oh,
that's a shame.
That was not a good feeling.
I can just have your tea.
Oh man.
Then move on when once ready.
I think I consider purchasing an option, but normally when you have one of them, it's not very significant. I feel
right. So yeah, you can notice with the speed. Yeah, it has all those perks. That it's giving you. It lists the perks for everyone, which is pretty helpful.
Yeah,
I'm glad that you kind of did that.
Oh dear, Chapter 7.
The little text that they have at the beginning of each stage reminds me of like R-Type. I think Final had stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I love those poems. It's you know what? I wanted to give a shout out to who helped you with this? Sarah Chan. She's known as Sarah Chan in IRC, or Sarah Lean that assisted with a lot of your guys' poems.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that might have been her. Yeah, she hangs out in the Schmuck Sires.
Yeah.
Shout outs to her.
So glad we could finally do a Rockin' Android. I kept on telling her, I was like, you know, we're going to feature a Rockin' Android game on SCG Weekly. We're going to do it. And then finally we got to do it. So this one's for you, Sarah.
Woo!
If I have her on someday.
Yeah.
She'd appreciate it. Yeah.
I have another Rockin' Android app for sure.
Yeah, for sure. We're going to do that. Definitely more Rockin' Android games, because we want to give a lot of love to these developers that are putting out these shmups and localizing these Dojin games, you know?
Yeah.
As an aside, from the G-Rev interview, the president was talking about like how shmups may not be surviving along, you know, as a general developer, but it might will just go to the doujin scene, so we might need to prepare for that to look for the future of shmups. So
yeah,
it's a good point that he kind of made there. Because there are plenty of, like, yeah, there are plenty of the doujins out there.
And, yeah.
You know, we can just, you know, try our best to give the support to, you know, many of them, the various developers.
Yeah.
What is going on?
Yeah. Wow, this is intense.
Oh, so this boss. Oh, boy.
Yeah, this gets pretty crazy near the end.
Yeah, it gets pretty tough.
Get hit. Gotta recharge. Wow, that's taking a long time to get back to the barrier. Wow.
I think the more times you get hit, the longer it takes to actually regenerate your... I believe that's a thing.
Something else that's a thing is that
you can, when you get hit without your shield, you can also get hit again without your shield if you don't let it recover. So you can actually lose 2 lives or even more if you don't let it fully recharge.
Okay.
So, I found that out a hard way.
So, don't get hit right after one. Try to at least let it recharge a bit.
You don't get invincibility or a new shield by dying, so that's it's important. So I think right here, I think I get quite a bit of coin that I'm... Yeah, look at that.
Wow.
Oh, suck all
must
that
have
money.
Used some good SSs there. I didn't
this. So now I think what's coming up is the last level, so I'm going to have to... I'm thinking about the wisest way to spend my coins here.
Take a little sip of tea.
Yeah, this is the tea break.
Yeah, meditate on, like, what should I do? What should I do?
What's really nice, though, about this game is that there's no real right or wrong way to go about things normally. It's very, like, oh, yeah, look at that.
Hmm. The little quotes. I was saying before we started the episode, but they remind me of like the little cheesy lines from Final Fantasy VIII's intro.
Yeah.
I love the cheesy lines. You're like, yeah, the sky blank, the heart open wide.
Like those, I don't know why. I guess there was like something appealing about that. I mean, between a lot of game developers.
Yeah, why not? Because, like, that's the way I think about, like, shmups. They're kind of like the poems of games, you know? Just...
It can be very short, yet very sweet.
Yeah, yeah. And, definitely poetry. Poetry, you know?
Yeah.
Well, those RPGs are, like, maybe the novels of video games. Yeah. But these are poems. Sweet poems.
Badass poems.
Yeah!
Badass with a lot of text.
By Charles Bukowski or something.
Yeah, that's right. We always go all the way. Why even try?
Yeah. This is the famous SCG Weekly episode that had one of the super player guys we had on actually quote a Charles Bukowski poem.
Yeah. Wow.
For his inspiration.
It was really, really
God
good.
God damn it. Fucking fart.
Is that your dog?
Hey, whose dog was that?
Whose dog was that?
Soda?
Dog, no.
Anyway. Forget the dog.
Oh, one more randomness. Yeah. Okay. Right,
so what's going on in this last stage? Like, you got a lot of these, like, bosses appearing.
Yep, so you got the big guy. And I believe it's the second boss coming back at you, but
the enemy designs are really interesting.
Yeah, I'm trying to like find like a good comparison. Like, what do they remind me of? But I don't know. They're just so. I really haven't seen much like their like the design.
Yeah, they're pretty unique.
So this was really confusing to me the first time I played this and got to this point. Like, oh, that wasn't too bad. And then it kind of does this.
Yeah.
And it is like, oh.
This big guy appears. He's got multiple sections, right?
Yeah. What's also really cool is that you can go about, you know, destroying those sections in multiple ways. I tend to like to go after the lasers first because of, well, that.
Yeah, those lasers are rough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of lasers. Like in Dotonpachi DFK, laser reels, no.
Ugh.
Don't like lasers.
Anything but the laser wheels.
Anything.
Curvy lasers. Perky lasers are a big no.
This is like a Gygas moment in the game.
Yeah, that's what I was getting too. It was the weirdest.
Now that I think about it, and I see like all the red and like just the amorphous figure, and the creepy music.
Oh, that music would just look good. That's Gygas. Another thing I like about this game. The music really fits the tone for whatever you're really going for.
Yeah. It does. Yeah, that's badass.
Yeah.
And then I was like, yay, I did it. I'm all done. I finished the game. And, well.
Yeah. You're not quite sure.
Oh, boy. I think there was a point where I actually beat him and I just kind of put my controller down and I saw the red. I'm like, oh no.
You're like, oh dang.
And I rushed to pick up my controller again. Just.
Oh, look at those. That red is bubbling up from me.
Yeah, I really enjoyed this part. So like you have like these crystals that are like a orbit around the boss that you have to destroy before you can damage the boss, right?
Yeah.
So they're just kind of going every which way, and you're like a really nasty bee just fucking going at everything here.
Yeah. I believe this is this. I can't remember what time this is. Like I've actually gotten to this point, but it's like almost essential that you try to. You know, do as much damage as you. Oh dear.
When you, you can.
Yeah. Because there's a couple of nasty attacks that he has, and it's just you'll end up doing that for a while, and he'll just put you in a pattern where you can't really focus on doing damage to him. So it's very important that you just.
So you're like not to worry about those destructible bullets because at this point your shot is basically protecting you.
Yeah. Oh, it's this. This is the.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
This is. Oh wow, that's even more awesome on the map now that I look at that. Wow.
Yeah, this part's badass.
Yeah, this is where you really. Or getting your strafe block. You know, getting that down is the best. Oh dear. Yeah, so now he's back to doing this.
Yeah. Oh, I see. Okay, you activated or wait. No, you didn't. I don't know.
Oh, that's there. Oh,
that's just with the music. It's like depressing.
A little bit,
just a tiny bit.
Wait, there's more video.
Yep, I still try going after it.
Nice. I didn't understand the purpose behind my life. Hopefully, you understand in exchange for. I feel there are things that can't be expressed through words. Only someone who wishes with all.
Oh.
That's the classic. Can't really read it, though.
Yeah, no, I think there was another person at Anime Expo who was saying, you know, why does this game have a shield or something along the lines of that? You know, doesn't that make the game a little bit too easy? And I think my response was along the lines of, it makes this game playable.
Yeah,
because like without a like in a game like Toho or a Gradius or Gundamonium or whatever. It's like a shield is a little bit much, but you know, because it has, you know, set bullet patterns. But in this, it's just like you almost need a shield.
Yeah, you really do. I mean, you get hit a lot. Like you probably hit probably at least 20 times.
Yeah.
At least. And you know, there are still repercussions to it, because, yeah, like you say, the barrier takes longer to recharge, so you still want to avoid being hit.
Yeah.
Obviously.
But for also the point, you know, the top scores, you know, getting hit is essential to getting the points, so it's also...
Yeah. Kind of at both ends of the spectrum there.
Yeah. There's a very, very clever design, I think.
Yeah, this game's pretty deep, like, more than I thought it would be
Yeah, when I was playing this in, I think it was pre-translated, I was like, I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah.
I was just like, I don't understand, but...
What do?
Oh, pretty much.
What?
Am I in the Twilight Zone?
Like, yeah, how did your demos go over at Anime Expo, by the way? Get a lot of interest, people coming over and going?
Yeah, I think it was overall well received. Uh-huh. A lot of people were definitely interested in it. And I think, you know, because it's a little bit, I'm going to say a little bit easier than a standard bullet hell for the most part. You know, it's a little bit, you know, newbie friendly, so.
It's pretty much like arena shooter-esque as well, which I think a lot of people could kind of identify with. I mean, comparing, I guess, you know, to Geometry Wars, I guess, is the example I'm thinking of.
Yeah.
I haven't really played that much myself.
I haven't played that in a long time.
I'll do Geometry Wars for an episode.
Yeah.
Just for the hell of it.
No, why not?
It's Geometry Wars.
But yeah, no, someone else brought this up. It was like, oh, you know, there's so many bullets on the screen. There's so many enemies on the screen. I'm going to go onto the other side of the map, take a breather, and then I'm going to go right back at it. And I thought that was a really interesting way of going about that, where, you know, if you want to make the game a little bit easier on yourself or, you know, you need to give yourself a breather, you can move back and just kind of...
Yeah, they give you that room, it looks like, yeah. You get that room.
Yeah. I think that went a little bit better than last time, I think.
So how about that multiplier? Do you know much about that? It said you had a multiplier of 11.
I think it's how many enemies you destroy, I believe. I'm not 100% confident on that answer, but... I think that's what it
is. Do you know if there's like a chaining, like an enemy destruction chaining mechanic that's actually playing into?
I believe so, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems like that might be in there.
Yeah. With all of the enemies, it kind of makes sense for the most part. Yeah.
Yeah. There are a lot.
Yeah. And right there, I use an SS trying to finish this as soon as I possibly can.
Jesus, that was like fireworks right there.
Cool. Yeah, I'm definitely wanting that guard plus.
Oh.
Sorry. You're like, that guard, I needed it.
Oh man.
That is such a nasty, nasty attack. If you're just not fast enough.
Yeah,
or you don't make those tight turns.
Yeah, I suppose if you didn't level up the speed at all, you might be screwed here.
Yeah. But I also don't know if it's, you know, due to, like, it moves at your kind of pace. Or if it, so I, at this point, I'm just moving.
Gobalt said the multiplier is related to when you hold the bomb button, if he does. When you hold, okay.
That's good to know.
So yeah, good demonstration though. Good play. Thank you for that. You have to, people have to see the ending for themselves, right?
Yeah, that was totally on purpose.
No spoiling on that one. Of course, it is localized, so we have that benefit now.
Yeah. It's also really nice to know that there's a couple of different difficulty settings as well. So you kind of like get your, after you beat it normally. Couple of times you unlock another difficulty and it's like the same game but much harder.
Was the next one like something like true mode or something like that?
Yeah,
I remember. I think I saw that.
Yeah, I haven't really dabbled around with that too much.
And then then you unlock the new weapons as well for every playthrough.
Yep, new weapons, so, like, new options, and
so it's like every time you play, like, you get to change it up a bit. Really, they get to play it different every time, it seems. Be a good, kind of an overall good thing about the game is that, you can play it in a lot of different ways. We've kind of had a lot of examples throughout the episode talking about, the various ways that, for newbies, advanced, it's really quite diverse.
Yeah.
A lot more diverse than I thought it could be, I guess.
Yeah, definitely in the same boat in that regard as well. Like,
and
just playing in this in Japanese was just.
and like, you don't need a great computer either to play this one, I believe. So, yeah. I think anyone could probably pick it up. So, what are the best ways to get this game?
I would like to say Steam, but that's not a thing quite yet. But at the moment, we have like this game on Gamersgate. We have it on Amazon, Digital Rice if you're in the UK, Desora. Did I mention Desora?
Someone was talking about Desora not working for UK. So you actually have it on Digital Rice for UK.
Yeah, we have.
So there you go.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And then, we'll have, various links for that in the YouTube description once I get this posted. I'll get those from you. But, what is it, like $5 mostly around, or is it 10?
I believe it's $5.
Okay. Yeah, that's a really good deal.
it's really good.
For the price of a combo meal, you can get this glorious game
and make all sorts of combos. Some
suppliers even.
People linking the Desura version. Okay, cool. What do we got for final thoughts on this one? It's pretty badass, I think. I'm glad we got to have you on because we did kind of learn some advanced things in reference to the usage of the bombs, getting the coins. So this should definitely be a good supplement to people who do pick up the game and that type of thing.
Yeah, guys, get Deidre empty. We'd love to have you back, G-cubed, and feature more Rock and Android stuff.
Yeah, thank you.
I want to buy the soundtrack.
I do too.
Very zoofing.
This soundtrack, so good.
Soundtrack is quite good. All right. I don't know what else to say. This has been pretty awesome. Pick it up, try it out. You ain't got no reason not to. And then play some Defender once you're done with that.
Yeah. And pick up all the other Rock and Android games. So, oh, by the way, guys, we're going to try to do a giveaway of codes.
Oh, right, yeah. Please.
You were gracious enough to give me. So post in the SDG weekly thread, and I'll do a random drawing by the end of the weekend and give away some of these codes to Deodra Empty and also Cloud Phobia that we hope to feature on SGG Weekly again. So thanks to Ken Rock Android.
Yeah, props to those for those codes. And when Frenetic says the SGG Weekly thread, he means the thread on the Shmups forum. So I'll provide a link to the forum. So if you want to register and get a chance at these codes, we'll do a drawing for all the people who post on that thread. So I should say like SCG Weekly 33 Diadrampty. So that should be good. All right, well, let's wrap it up then. It's been really great having you GameCubed. I can't think of a good way to end this except this game is awesome. Tea time is good.
Yeah.
And every
tea time is best time.
Pip pip cheerio. I like mine with cream and double sugar, please.
Definitely. All right. Well, that's gonna do it for SCG Weekly 33. Thanks for dropping by, everyone. And let's have this on YouTube in a bit in HD quality. Props to Soda.
Yeah, Soda Stream.
Sweet. Yeah. All right. Take it easy, everyone.
Bye bye.
Bye.